Now I'm moving to the fourth Sampatitas. In the morning, we are talking about the independent Sampatitas. Now I'm going to focus on the fourth Sampatitas. In the morning itself, I already highlighted that there is a three types of titas. The other one is called one Sampatitas, independent Sampatitas, and fourth Sampatitas. The condition to apply a fourth Sampatitas, see here, for applying the fourth Sampatitas, the condition, one is called test, okay, then sample group. So in this case, the test should be two tests, okay? The test should be two, and sample should be only one group. For example, you are comparing with the pre and post test, pre-test and post-test, therefore there is a two test, or before the treatment or after the treatment. The sample, you are taking the consideration only the control group or in experimental group. If you are taking the consideration only single group, if you want to compare the single group of the two tests, you can go with the per sample test. Why is called per sample in the sense? Because the samples are correlated. Because you are using the same sample group for the pre-test and post-test. Therefore, we can adopt the per sample test. In this case, see here, the pre-test score and post-test scores in the data sets I given here, the serial number is 15. It means that there is a 15 students. They wrote the pre-test examination and post-test examinations. It means the both the groups members are, I mean, single group only. So I may treat it as a control group. I may treat it as an experimental group. In this case, this is an experimental group, 15 students. They wrote the pre-test and post-test. For this, we have to comparing the mean scores of the pre-test and post-test of a single group. We can depend on the per sample titers. For doing the per sample titers, I'm moving to the path of the data analysis through the Excel. Go to the data. Once again, we know the data. Once you go to the data, go to the data analysis. Then after data analysis, you are getting this kind of interface there. Our intention to do a per sample t-test. So already the morning we attempted the t-test, two sample assuming equal variances and two sample assuming unequal variances. These two things we acted only for the independent sample t-test only. In the case of per sample t-test, the first one, the t-test per two samples for means you have to select, because it is compared to the post sample t-test. Therefore, you can select this option only. After selecting the options, click OK button. Once you click the OK button, it tells the variable input range. We have the two variable. Pre-test is a variable, post is a variable. Therefore, what I am going to do? So I am selecting the pre-test score as a variable one. Then variable two, I am selecting the post-test scores as a variable two. So therefore, I am giving as an input. Input I'm given, and I'm already selected the pre-test and post-test as a heading here. Therefore, I may select the labels also, labels as an options here. So after giving the input, I need to generate the output. Therefore, I'm clicking the output option. In the output option, I'm keeping the cursor in the output range. I'm keeping the cursor somewhere outside. This is for, I'm keeping it as G19. As output, I want to feel to be generate the output in this particular box. Therefore, I'm selecting this region. Then after this, I'm clicking the OK. Once I click OK, now you are getting the scores. This is a per sample t-test. So normally the per sample t-test, we need the patient correlation value also. See here, the same results may comes here. That's why I told. For cross checking your attempting of the data analysis with your practice, that is why I'm given some kind of output also as a display for you. You can cross check whether your input, your output is look like the same of the output which I'm already given in the data sets. Now in this case, the mean scores or the pre-test is 47.66, post is 59.73, variances is nothing but standard deviation square. For the pre-test group, 238.52, post 327. Observations is nothing but the number count n is equal to 15, because both the samples are 15 only. Then here the correlation value, because first sample t-test, the first sample t-test while adopting, we may getting some kind of correlation value. Even the SPS also, we may get this correlation value. That value is 0.53. It means that it is moderate level of correlations between the pre-test and post-test. Then the DF value is 14. The formula for DF is n minus 1 in the case of the Toads and the Peters. Therefore, n is ours is 15, then minus 15 minus 1 equal to 14. That's why it's coming. The t-score is 2.8691. Normally, the t-score's value is always a positive because we are comparing the t-test value. We already know that modulus of m1 minus m2. Modulus represent all the negative value, meaning converts it positive only. It means that we are checking the differences only. We are not checking the directions. Okay. So in this case, the magnitude, we may select only the magnitude value of the t-scores only. Therefore, the t-scores value is 2.89. Normally, we may select the two sample, null hypothesis only. Therefore, we may see the p-value of the two-tailed because we are adopting null hypothesis. The p-value in this case, so I'm typing the p-value. P-value in this case, 0.01. If you compare with our level of significance, so our level of significance is 0.05 level. For example, I'm saying it's 0.05 level. And 0.05 level. Therefore, the p-value is less than 0.05. It means it is significant. It is significant at 0.05 level. Significant at 0.05 level. 0.05 level. Even for the 0.01 also, it equals. For example, I'm taking the consideration 0.01 level. What it comes? So p-value is 0.01 is equal to p-value is equal to 0.05. So in the case of significant value, like alpha value is equal to the alpha value. Alpha value is nothing but our test of significance value. The alpha value in this case 0.01. So therefore, the both the cases p less than 0.05 or p is equal to 0.01. So the output, the findings may comes like this only, the significant at 0.01 level as well as the 0.01 level. So what it means in the sense, we may come for conclusion based on the p-value. There is a significant difference between the pre-test and post-test scores of control group, or there is a significant difference between the pre-test and post-test scores of the experimental group. So this is where we can do a poor sample t-test. So this is the findings. Normally we may take the consideration only this much value only. Just I am making the marker of the which value we have to take considerations for keeping the table. So while so don't take all the values in the case of the thesis purpose. The red mark values is more than enough to write the interpretations. These are the values that you can incorporate in the during the research report. So other things you can be skipping. So I hope now you understand.